It's hard to pinpoint the exact time at which the previously hapless Mets became contenders. In fact, they actually lost to the Montreal Expos in the expansion team's very first game. But on June 3rd, the Mets won over the 500 mark for the first time that late in the season. And on June 15th, they acquired Donn Clendenon, who became the slugging first baseman they desperately needed to drive in some runs. Clendenon, in fact, drove in the lead or winning run in his first 16 games as a Met. And by the beginning of July, the race was really on.
Gil Hodges had talked to me and said that he needed a leader on the team. Mm-hmm. And I was stepping into that role. And it's hard to become a leader on a bunch of guys. But when you walk on a team, you don't say too much. And the first 18 games you play in, you drive in the winning or the tying run, you become a leader. They listen to because you have performed. You let your productivity speak for you.
Ace pitcher Ferguson Jenkins rallied for an amazing win in the bottom of the ninth.
Mets have won the championship of the Eastern Division of the National League. Look at that scene. They can't hold the fans. The Mets are being swamped.
The Mets. One more in first game. I mean, Seaver could hit you in the eye with his fastball and not black your eye. Mm-hmm. And he was tight. We all were tight. We're in the World Series. And the press are saying the Baltimore is the greatest team since the Yankee dynasty. Mm-hmm. You know, and they got the Robertson, Brooks, and it went down. And so I just told the guys after the game, they beat us 4-1. And I just asked, we had a kind of philosophy that when I went and asked Gil for management to leave, the coaches and stuff, they all got the hell out of there and let the players talk. Mm-hmm. That was because we had to police ourselves. And I just told them, I says, guys, think about it though. Seaver sucked. And Seaver was right there. I mean, that was not the Tom Seaver that brought us down the stretch. Mm-hmm. You know? And I said, we're going to kick their butts. I said, Cuellar could not pitch in the National League. That's why he came to the American League.
I said, to McNally, I said, he's a left-hander. And I always felt that I could hit anybody if they threw from the left side because I had longer to look at it. And I told him we were going to do it. We started talking about it, and this is a rah-rah thing. Mm-hmm. And we got out there the next night, the next day. We started off slow, and I think I hit a home run the first time up. And that started everything going. Mm-hmm. Then we started playing good ball, and they tied up when we won it. And you could see the guys getting that confidence back.
But the next day, the Orioles took an early 3-0 lead. Then, in the bottom of the sixth inning, Cleon Jones of the Mets alleged he had been hit in the foot by pitcher Dave McNally.
Game five. Tell me about Cleon Jones. Cleon Jones and the shoe polish incident. By the way, the umpire, just a little local flavor, was Lou DeMuro.
Yeah.
DeMuro's just passed away, but Dunkirk, New York, which is you went through it.
Yeah. We started off. Cousy had made a couple of mistakes, and you got to realize that. See, good pitching is always going to stop good hitting. Mm-hmm. Good pitching will always slow down good hit. You keep your great hitters to one hit in the ballpark. That's what Sandy Koufax, the Drysdales, the Gibsons, when they were on their game. So Kuzman had made a couple mistakes, and we were three runs down. One of the things we need was base runners. So when the ball came inside, I thought it hit him on the shoe. And Cleon stammered around. You know, he pointed down like that, and then Cleon said, "Well, the helmet, I want to hit." So I had to go tell Cleon, "Get your ass to first base," you know. And DeMuro, you know, didn't know what the hell was going on. I said, "DeMuro, they polish our shoes every day. Every day. So if you hit him on his shoe at all, on his foot at all, it would have shoe polish on it, wouldn't it?" Mm-hmm. So So he called it out there, and because someone had thrown the ball over. And Gil walked out there with the ball and had shoe polish on it. So then Magnetta started arguing. So I said, get your ass back out to the mound and throw that shit up here, you know, to piss him off.
Yeah.
And he was, got pissed, and he tried to throw one by me, and I hit it out,
yeah.
You know. So that made it brought us to
the turn of the game.
That was the impetus we needed.
Then, in the bottom of the sixth inning, Cleon Jones of the Mets alleged he had been hit in the foot by pitcher Dave McNally. The umpire hadn't seen it.
Did he hit him? Oh, he hit him. How wonderful. Amazing. It's amazing.
Hodges called for the ball and pointed to a minute speck of shoe polish. Jones went to first.
And here comes Earl Weaver. You could bet on that. There was nobody out. The Mets had a base runner, and Donn Clendenon is up, and the Mets fans have come alive here.
Next up was Donn Clendenon.
Deep left field to the warning track.
His home run into the left field stand scored Jones and brought the Mets to within one run. The miracle Mets had won the World Series, 4-1.
Six.
I felt we were going to beat them all along. You know, because when they had, the Baltimore at that time could come back on you. Mm-hmm. They had great hitting and great defense and good pitching. But when Weiss hit the home run to tie the game up, you saw Brooks. If you go back, I have the film. I can show you Brooks went. And the same thing, I looked out in right field, Frank.
Yeah.
And when the pro professionals drop their head like that, I mean, it's over.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think they realized that there was nothing they could have done to beat us. You know, we pulled plays out of our ass. You know, that was the dumbest catch. It was the greatest dumbest catch I've ever seen in my life. You know, anytime you run and dive at the ball, I'm not even looking at it going into your glove. When Spoda dove, he dove like this.
Yes.
He was looking at the scoreboard. I mean, if that ball gets by, the whole complexion of the game changes.
Mm-hmm.
The tying run, the tying run scores, and the winning run advances the second.
Yeah.
You know, and so Gil, when I came back in, he went out looking like this, and Gil did that to me. So, I mean, I had to put him down in the dugout. I mean, down in the town and tell him, Sabota, God damn it, where are you thinking about? I made a great catch, Ron. He went, his eyes, he was so fired up, the adrenaline was flowing. But that play really put another nail in their coffin. We were destined to win.
The champion Mets singing, You've Gotta Have Heart. So let's have a fine...
Chin above the floor. Mister, you can be a hero.